spell.
Master Gundam and FU UN SAI KI. Let me start off by saying, this is the last of the G Gundams I have to review. And from now on, my reviews will be request only, meaning if you want something request, you're going to have to ask for it. Also going to review the FU UN SAI KI. This is supposed to be the extreme articulation figures. But anyway, if you want anything reviewed, you're gonna have to ask to have it reviewed, request it. That's why I chose Master Gundam for my, I guess, last non-request review. So, here we go. Let's start off with the FU UN SAI KI. Supposed to be a horse, but this looks more like a unicorn. Tail has a little booster on the back. The legs are on ball joints. The knees, yeah, it has guards on its knees. See? They even move. Legs move. This leg's on the ball joint too. This part up here's on the ball joint. The knee is just on the simple joint. The head is on a ball joint, but it can't really move because of how tight they made the it. The tail is also on a ball joint. The horn can come out for some reason. Looks better without the horn. I think it looks better without the horn. Master Gundam can ride on it. I'm not going to change his hand just to show that he can hold both. He is a pain in the butt to get on here if you want to pose him, but I'll just take the wings off. It's supposed to be extreme articulation. It would have been nicer if they would have put stiffer joints on the FU UN SAI KI. But, there you go, Master Gundam. FU UN SAI KI's not a bad figure. The legs are a little floppy, loose right in here. They want to collapse on you. Same with the front legs. You can tell how easy that moves. Back legs are not too bad, not as bad as the front legs are. Nicely detailed. Surprisingly, it looks like it's showing up. But that's basically it for the FU UN SAI KI. Does anyone know why they made it where that horn can come off of there? You can not put it in. You cannot take this out and put it in like this. Okay, on to Master Gundam now. I'll just set Psyche for in the background. Okay, the accessories Master Gundam came with. Came with 8 changeable fists and it came with forearms too. These are extended forearms. As you can tell there, they're extended out. That's where those are not. Here's the better view. Came with 2 of the darkness finger, I think that's what he called it. 2 hands to hold the weapons. 2 fists. And then 2 karate chop hands. Let's see, where'd I put it? And it also came with his signature cloth beam weapon. I'm not sure what they called this weapon. But this is his beam cloth that he uses. All you can really do is use it like a sword. That's it. That's all you can do with the beam cloth. Let's talk about his capes. That came with 2 capes. That came with the defense mode cape. They actually did...